when the husband dies, then she could remarry. Why? To prevent fornication and adultery. But that's just us. Now, other people, the way that they practice polygamy, we don't practice it that way because it's unclean and it's wicked. Like a lot of these people out here that practice polygamy, they're having threesomes, and that's unclean. The book of Leviticus tells us that, you know, that's fornication. So we, you know, we're not, that creates problems. And not only, if a man is sticking his rod into one woman and he goes in another woman, bacteria could actually be spread that way. So the Most High put these things down for good reasons. So I guess my next question would be, what do you think about some women that say, I'd rather be alone instead of be involved in that kind of relationship, yet they're single and they have children, but they'd rather be alone?
My biggest thing is, a lot of times people do stuff, but it's because they're incomplete within themselves and they lack. And also, a lot of people aren't raised with certain moral standards of value, or even understanding or overstanding the role of a man, the role of a woman, and how things are. Because again, a lot of it has been to cause separation between the man and the woman. So you see more women acting like men and more men acting like women, and not getting back to how things are and how they should be. So a lot of times it's because either ignorance or a lack of knowledge or influence or a lack of self-love, because, you know, women say that all the time, but that's not true. You know what I'm saying? And just like so many times they want to put themselves in a man's place, but there's so many things you can't do because God didn't create you to do that. You see what I'm saying? You're created a certain way. Just like a man gives, a woman receives. Everything is the way it is for a reason. And people lose sight of that. And, oh, I don't need a man. Oh, but you do. But that's whatever you got going on as to why you say that and you speak like that. But again, it's a lot of incomplete people, because a lot of people say, oh, well, I've never met a good man who did this and did that. But again, a lot of times what you're getting is a reflection of what is internally in you. And that's what you're attracting. And as long as you aren't where you should be, you're going to keep meeting people who line up with that. So these women say that, and I don't feel it's valid. And then the thing is too, again, my personal belief is that it is not in a man's nature to just want one woman at all.
Whoa, what did you say?
It is not.
Can you repeat that again?
It is not in a man's nature to be with one woman. It's not.
They're not going to like you. They're not going to like you for that statement. They're not going to like you for your honesty. Hurts,
but it'll set you free. You know, it's the truth. I mean, think about it. Look at it as a whole. You know, again, it's like, oh, well, let me check his phone. Let me do this. Let me do that. And it's never anything against that woman. That's just how that man is built. That's how he was created. There is literally more women than men walking the face of this earth. So even if there was one for each one, the math ain't mathing. Somebody gonna be out and it's not gonna be good. So it's physically not even possible to be monogamous. Physically.
Moshe, what do you think about what the sister just said?
Shalom, everyone. So I'm just taking this in, and I would love to hear, you know, these are some really good points, and I think she's a really well-spoken sister. So all praises to the Most High for that. I just would like to hear, I know we know everything is, I've been listening to a lot of the sisters who are in polygamous relationships. We've seen, not to bring this up, but Yehoshabim situation. And so I think a lot of women also get afraid because, yeah, there are a few men who can do this. But I'm hearing, I wrote a list down. I want to go get it in a few, but I want to listen more. But there are situations where it's not healthy. In fact, there are children suffering because of this. And so I want to hear all tonight about the negative and
because
the positive.
Because of polygamy, you say children are suffering?
No. Because of the situation is not right with the polygamy.
because of the situation, how it started, how it began. We have, you know, I'm not saying that I'm against polygamy at all. I'm saying that I don't think it's for everyone. I don't think a lot of men can do it. I think if they're under the Ruach of the Most High, yeah. But I believe that there are some who should not do it, as Kahan said, I think, last week. But I would love to hear, you know, I love to hear how this sister said she's definitely close to her sister wives. I think that's beautiful that they work together, that they, you know, it seems like a bond. So I would love to hear more about that, because as I'm speaking to a lot of the women who are in polygamous relationships, some of the complaints that I hear or the trouble that comes is that the man has barely enough time for himself, and that the first wife always feels like it's always good for the second or third wife, right? Because they're the most desirable for that moment. But the first wife usually sometimes feel unheard or lack of something thereof, you know? And so I'm wondering, how do you guys deal with that if you ever experience that? I'm learning, you know, this is all new to me. So I'm just learning, guys, humbly learning.
So let me ask something. Now, obviously, a woman can't have it all, right? Think about this right here, Moshe. Now, because you just said that some sisters say the husband hardly has time for himself, right? You still with me, Moshe?
Yes, yes. Sorry, guys.
All right. You said the husband hardly have time for himself, right? First of all, if a man is doing this and he's doing it appropriately, he's not going to be a regular guy, right? Especially, see, in the scriptures, we learned that a lot of these women was actually helping the man out. They wasn't just sitting there doing anything, right? They was helping him breathe. That's one of the benefits of polygamy, is you're helping to build an empire, right?
Family.
You're helping to build something strong. It's not, sex is the last thing on the totem pole. When you really look at it scripturally, many men got involved in polygamy to, like, for financial reasons and to build up things, right? For a lot of the women that Solomon got with, even though he took women into other nations, he wasn't supposed to do it. It was for political and financial benefits, right? To have better connections. So now they are supposed to be helping him build something, but you got to keep in mind, if this man going to be there providing, he's not going to have a lot of time, because you can't have both, right? You can't have a man that's high in status that's making a lot of revenue, and then you want him to be able to, that's not going to happen. It's unrealistic. So that's, it's either one, it's either the lifestyle, or you spending time with him, then you can just get a regular guy. It's a hard truth of it. It's going to just be a regular guy. So you may as well get one of those Israelite guys on the corner so he could put you on food stamps and get you to take care of him. Why?
No, I get that kind of. No, that's true. That's true. I'm not saying that about the time. I mean that some of the things that were expressed to me through various women, right? This is just various women, were that they started like, okay, naturally, instinctively, they said to me that they naturally, instinctively, when you have children, right, you automatically are like, okay, now this is my own. Now I know that's a selfish thing, because we should be thinking, this is, you know, this is a unit, you know, we're all raising up children. But they start to worry when they start to watch the man going from woman to woman. Usually they start to see, okay, he's not satisfied. He's taking another one. Is he going to take another one? So that starts to worry them, because now they're thinking about their children's future. Yeah. So now I'm thinking, you know, so I'm like trying to learn. I want to see. So I love that this sister has a positive. I'm going to be honest. She's like the first one who's under the Ruach, under the law. She's going by the Bible. Well, she's not doing this threesome stuff that I have honestly.
Well, we don't know. We haven't asked her that yet. I just put it out there. We're not supposed to do it. She did tell me she has a mother that's Jewish and another one that's an Israelite.
Because I did see her page. Is that your page, since when you got the red hair?
Yeah, that's me.
Oh, okay. So she's not into the Bible. So
I don't know.
I am. Yeah, definitely. I don't know if you can see me. I'm over here like multitasking. But so the thing is that no, I don't do any of that either. You know, we have the Bible and standards and principles that are set. You know what I'm saying? So no, it's not one of those where I'm sleeping with them and we're doing things. You know, it's not that kind of situation whatsoever. So no, it's how it's supposed to be. You know what I'm saying? The man is the head. You know, I submit to my husband, and you know, we are there for each other as sisters and look out for each other. And your concerns are valid, because you can have issues no matter what the dynamic it is, you know, whether it's just you and a husband, whether it's you and sister wives, you're going to have things that are going to come up. You're going to have jealousy. You're going to have things, and you have to address that, because, you know, but you also have to have emotional integrity. You have to have emotional intelligence, because it takes extra effort, because in a monogamous relationship, it's just you and that person. Well, in poly, it's a different woman. It's a different personality. It is those different things. And even sometimes too, maybe how I discipline my child may not be how you discipline yours, but that's why you have to be strong within self. And you, again, have to have that emotional intelligence. You have to have that communication, because it's key. Yes, because girl, if you don't have those basics and you don't have that within self, it doesn't matter if it's just me and Earl, you know, it's going to be issue no matter what's going on. You see what I'm saying?
That's true.
So the thing in life is it starts here, no matter whether it's two of us or three of us or five of us. If I don't have it here and he doesn't submit to that, then how can he do anything more for me than he can't do for himself? You see what I'm saying? Yeah. And when it comes to a sister wife, I want for her what I want for myself. So if there is an issue, she should be able to come to me. Or if it's something, she should be able to go to him, because I wouldn't want to feel like I'm being left out. Or even if I'm feeling some type of way, hey, I want to talk about this. Because a yes, lot of times in yes, life, it's the stories we tell ourselves. Because perception is reality, but also sometimes it is your perception and it's not reality. So a lot of times you have to get clarity. You have to do your diligence, and you have to say, okay, is that me tripping? Or is that really what this is? You know what I'm saying? And it's so easy to get caught up. You know what I'm saying? So even if, you know, you feel, wait a minute, you wasn't doing that with her, how you was doing with me. Again, you need to be able to address that. But you also need to be able to receive that and have full accountability. And have that dialogue, you know, and have that conversation.
And I love her for this. I want to say I agree with you. Like, I feel like if it's going to work, it would have to be that kind of beautiful attitude where, like as I said before, it's about the children. It has worked
absolutely
before. I've seen it work before. I've seen it in biblical times work before. So I would say, I can't say, no, that's not going to work. So that's why I love this perspective from her. Because I love how you said your sisters, how there's a sisterhood, right? And so
exactly,
that's beautiful. This is like the first example, to be honest, that I'm seeing. And I love that my sister don't got no hair. You know, it goes back to what Tazadok was saying. So you're just regular, you a woman of Elohim, you're the woman of the Most High, you're a woman of the Most High, and you know who you are.
Okay.
And I think that's beautiful how you guys communicate. Communication yes, is important.
It's key.
So I love that. And I want to hear more. Like, how did you guys, if you ever got into bumps, like what struggles did you see in the beginning? If you can help us with that. Because this is beautiful. I'm loving this. And I'm loving your openness. So I'm so thankful for you.
Oh, yes. I'm an open book. You know what I'm saying? So I got to be transparent. I got to keep it real. There's definitely been times that it was some feelings. And I was like, okay, wait a minute. And there's times where we even had to kind of like have mediation and like talk to each other and say, okay, this is what I felt, you know, or when you did this, this is how I felt, you know, like, were you throwing shade, or, you know, even maybe you did something that upset me. And a lot of times too, like, we'll do like a temperature check, you know, and we'll say, hey, because sometimes maybe you're not ready to talk and you don't want to be reactive and act hastily, or, you know, do something because you're just in your feelings. So a lot of times, you know, we'll call a family meeting and say, hey, you know, this is how I feel, you know, what did you mean by that, or why did you do that, you know. So I've had it to where there was a time that I was, you know, upset about something that took place, and so we literally sat around, you know, and we had, you know, someone in the family, you know, try to mediate, but to say, okay, this is what I took from it, because, you know, I speak, you speak, and then you assess it just from your vantage point, how you, you know, how you took it. Because sometimes we have to intercede for each other, you know, because sometimes maybe him and her are getting into it, you know, so I have to be unbiased and not take anybody's side. I just have to hear what you're saying, hear what you're saying, and say, okay, well, based on what I've heard, this is what it is. So there's
she's a beautiful soul. I love her soul, because for you to do that, I think that's beautiful. See, that's why I'm now I'm opening up, because I've heard a lot of negative parts of it. And I'm yes. like, wait a minute. Now, say you a woman and you're looking at it like that. You're like, oh, no, why would I want to get involved? But exactly. I'm about community and children. So yes. if I that would be the reason for my, you know, for me getting involved. I love children. I would love to raise them together. And you know, it would be great to be have a supportive family unit like that. I love Absolutely. How you all come together. That's amazing. That's amazing. So go ahead, girl. I'm listening. I'm here to learn.
No, so it's one of those things that it takes work, because, you know, poly is new for me. This was my very first poly relationship, but I'm very open-minded. And my thing is, and I'll tell anybody this, for me, you know, I was a daddy's girl. I'm the oldest of four. And that was the first man I've ever loved, the first man I've ever been with. And, you know, he was unfaithful to my mother, unfortunately. He's on wife number three, my grandfather. It was one of those things that, same thing. He left my grandma after 20 something years, had two more children. And even in relationships that I had, you know, I'm been married before, my husband now, and just been through life, been through relationships. And it's one of those things that cheating has always been an issue. Like, I could probably count on these two fingers sometimes. Someone has
toes.
Been...
You gotta add the toes with me.
Right. You know, where somebody, you know, maybe didn't do anything. But other than that, every relationship I've had, you know, it's ended up where, you know, you was unfaithful. You didn't want to do right. And so I say that to say, I said, well, if the very first man I ever loved did it, and you know, I've seen him whatever with my mother, my grandfather, well, there's got to be more to that. It's got to be something to it. But then it's just like, well, we've been taught our whole life, it's only one you and to him. And the reason why it's such a struggle, because it's not even just a black thing, this is all men. And the reason why it's such a struggle is because it is going against what is in you. So that has to be the hardest thing. Now, don't get me wrong, people do act out of integrity, and you have people who abuse things and who misuse things. So don't get me wrong, that happens no matter what. However, it'd be so much less drama and heartache and heartbreak and broken homes. You know, believe it or not, children struggle when they're in a single parent home, especially with the woman, because, you know, it's the reason God had a man and a woman to make a child, because you need that man. You need that masculine energy. You need that yes. discipline, that structure. You need what comes with a man. And as much as I love my son, I can't teach him how to be a man. There's a lot of things I cannot teach him. I can't show him. I can love him. And I did, you know, but there are certain things he lacked because he didn't have that male influence in his life. So yes. our black children, they suffer. They need them. They really
yes. And
I got some more questions for her. So so sister, so have you ever
I'm sorry.
Yeah. Have you ever had an issue with one of the sisters trying to plot against the other sister? and play that, you know, so sometimes women we try to make the other sister look bad in the face of the husband to try and turn him against her. Have you had to ever deal with any of those kind of issues? That one of the sisters went behind your back and said something to your husband to try and, you know, trying to just throw some salt on the relationship?